I told that a disadvantage of the vociferative language that suppose I write something here in high level language 3 + 2. You can easily understand that it will be 5. But in low level language, suppose I have written 1 0 1 0 plus 0 1 0 1, and I told it is 1 1 1 1. So it is difficult to guess what exactly it is. It is 10. If I convert decimal length, it is 10. It is 5. It is 15. That means we have seen it is easy to understand, but it is difficult to understand. Debugging is also a problem. Debugging means making program error free. Error free in the sense, suppose I have made any mistake here. I write written here 6. You suddenly start. This is error because it should be 5. We can easily debug. But if I mistake here something like this, you cannot instantly say that here it is error. So I mean to say that line that it is difficult to debug and difficult to understand, because machine level language use 0 and 1. It is easy for the machine, but it is difficult for the computer. It is machine dependent. This is very important point. Machine dependent means before writing computer program, computer programmer should know about the specification of hardware, computer's processor. That means it was a major problem with the machine level language before writing computer program. It should know the detail of the computer. That is, it is machine-dependent programming languages. After machine-level languages, this is also known as the fuzzy languages. After new languages, assembly-level languages, it existed in the second generation computer. It removed some barrier of the machine-level language, but it is also a low-level language. It is also near to the a program written in assembly language consists of series of instruction mnemonics that correspond to a stream of executable instruction when translated by an assembler that can be loaded into the memory and executed. That means in assembly language, in spite of writing everything in the 0101, it develops some mnemonics code. That means this code can be used for the particular task, and it is easy to remember. The code and program became less lengthy than the machine level language. This assembly language used keywords and symbols much like English to perform programming language. But at the same time, it introduced a new problem. What is the problem? We will discuss in this part. Mnemonics like move, add, sub, div, these are the mnemonics. Small code. Mnemonics mean, that means suppose these are the mnemonics, that is div, move, add, these are, there are many mnemonics code that are used by the assembly languages. But for the assembly languages, we need translator. That means we need translator in assembly languages. It has own translator. It has own translator. That means it uses assembler as a translator. Assembly language has its own translator. That means these translators only compile the assembly languages. This is a specific translator for the assembly language. It converts assembly language into the machine level language and machine level language into the assembly language. This translator was used by the what? Computer assembly programming language. Now, it was slower than the high level language, because for translating to communicate with the computer, they need the translator. That means it is time consuming, because it can't directly communicate with the computer. But there are some advantages. It was easier to understand as compared to the machine level language. Second one is that it is easy to locate and correct it, because you can easily see the symbols like English words. So you can easily find out where there is a bug, there is a error in the program. And it is also easily modified in comparison with the machine level language. Now come to the second point, disadvantage. Disadvantage, like machine level language, it is also machine dependent, and prior writing assembly language, programmer must know the specification of the computer. Now come to the high level language. If I talk about the high level language, it is just like a language we spoke in our daily life. Simple English statement like print, if, while, just giving a command to the computer. And this high level language is also translated into the low machine level language by using interpreter compiler. That means high level language very easy for the computer, but it is slower than machine level language and assembly language, because syntax are used and computer doesn't understand the huge syntax which is given in the English like statement. So it is slower than above languages. Now programmer written in high level language must need to be translated in machine level language. Some programming languages use a compiler to perform this translation. Compiler or interpreter. We can see high level language, Pardal, C, C++, Java, Basic, COBOL, Pascal, Python, these all are high level languages. So what are the main features of high level languages? They are user friendly. That means user can easily understand. Similar to the English vocabulary. That means easily to learn. Less time to write program. If you know the rules, syntax, you can easily develop a program. Less easier to maintain, and it is problem oriented. That means you can write program in a system and run to a different system. No need to have the same specification. That means before writing program, you don't know the hardware configuration of the computer. Other one, shorter than the low level equivalent, because it is obviously machine learning language was used. For writing a code, you have to use different symbol, it became lengthy. So in comparison of machine level language, the statement is shorter. Programming written in high level language can be translated into the machine level language. Therefore, appropriate translator should be installed in the computer. It is independent of the machine level language, I told you, because if you write a program in one system, you can run those languages into the other systems. But everything has advantage and disadvantage. This high level language also have some disadvantages. It needs a translator. Without translator, we can't run. That means it is slow. Now, the object first is generate object code. The object code generated by the translator might be inefficient compared to an equivalent assembly language programs. So today I am going to wind up. So today we have learned what is programming, who is a programmer, and what is a programming technique, and what is application programmer, and types of language, machine level language, assembly language, and high level language. Okay, thank you for watching video. Thank you.